Yeah, get ready for round two of the Illumination Ovation. It is coming tomorrow night at 8 o'clock. And if you missed the first one, here's some video of it. And here's how it works. Turn on your porch light or come out with a flashlight, candle, or even use your cell phone to shine a light while you are clapping and cheering. And it is a way to honor all the essential workers who are on the front line in the fight against the coronavirus.
Round two of the Illumination Ovation is tomorrow night at 8 o'clock and will continue every Tuesday evening until sundown. So share your photos and videos that you capture tomorrow night with the hashtag #LoveFromPGH and help spread the love.
I love this idea.
I do,
too.
And I heard Selena and I think Heather. Heather heard them cheering and
right.
screaming. Yeah,
yeah.
So it was pretty
it's
cool.
a great thing to show your mm-hmm. support. Well, before tomorrow night, we have some serious weather actually to deal with that could be coming through today. So let's get right to meteorologist Ron Smiley for the latest. And Ron, you're back after a week off. We missed you.
Thank you. I miss you guys as well. Glad to be back here as well. I actually got through that with a straight face, no laughing. I did actually miss you guys with my week off. Hey, let's take a look. I wanted to start you off. Tomorrow's going to be cooler for the illumination tomorrow night. There might be some bonfires actually going. 44 is the high temperature for Tuesday. Today, though, 68 degrees. We do have some issues out there. One of those is going to be the rain showers that are moving through right now. Hey, we do have some good news, though. It did look like we had the smallest of severe weather chances. That, at least at this point, just doesn't look like it's going to happen. What we are going to see, though, is some really strong winds setting up for the late morning hours and the afternoon. So just be aware of that. A lot of colors out there. The brownish color, that's going to be the wind advisory. That means wind gusts up to 50 miles an hour. The orange color you're seeing, that is a high wind warning. That's actually a step higher than the wind advisory. That means our wind gusts could top 60 miles an hour. That's mainly for elevated areas and then north of I-80 where that's setting in. Best or the strongest of the wind is likely to be in the morning hours, and then even in the afternoon hours, we'll be looking at some fairly strong wind setting up. Hey, just be aware and be prepared for that. I've been warning you all morning long. Make sure you try to go out in your yard and make sure everything's held down. You don't want to lose anything with those strong winds. There's your forecast for today. We're going to go officially 68 degrees for your high. We'll probably be hit pretty early, about 1 or 2 o'clock, cooling after that. And hey, coming up in about 30 minutes, I'll show you that 7-day outlook, including a chance for some snow this week.
All right. Thanks a lot, Ron. Well, we're going to take a quick break and be back with a different kind of traffic report from Selena Pompiani. You know her, of course, reporting like this.
No problem spots on Route 28 this morning. Taking a look at the big picture where we have a ton of green.
And now, even though there's really no traffic to report on these days, there's still a story and it could save you money. Selena will cover it for us coming up next.
Also ahead, helping parents, students, and teachers cope with the abrupt end to school as they knew it. Parenting expert Dr. G offers some solutions when PTO continues after this.